but I think we're sort of almost coming up to when you decided to leave LA. So I'd love to hear a little bit about what was going on in your career at that point, and did part of the decision come from you feeling like you were established enough, or did you just want to get away from LA, or like, because it's a really tough thing. I mean, I've moved out of LA too, but I did it when you could be much more portable, and it, my career changed a lot less than yours would have to when you moved out, because you were kind of on fire in a way. You know, so I'd love to talk a bit about that. And obviously, if there are any projects or any instruments you destroyed along the way you want to talk about first, we can do that. But
well, the story of me leaving LA was a very human story in that I wanted to have a family. And it was, this is kind of the story of women in these types of jobs where it really requires your full attention and absolute dedication and no days off and very little social time. It was, you know, I met a guy and it was a long distance relationship and we wrote back and forth. This is before email. We didn't, well, there was email, but we decided to write actual notes back and forth long distance. He lived in Northern California and was a railroader. He was outside of the business. I thought, well, here's someone, and we're both sober. And it's also an issue when you are, you know, dedicated to not fuck up with your drinking and whatever, that you spend time with someone who's of like mind. Very difficult to find these types of people in LA.
Yeah.
Especially to have a relationship with. So I made a huge decision. I was at the peak of my work, actually. I had work lined up and things were really happening. But I made that big decision to move up to Northern California and go have a family. And I took a year off. At first, it wasn't off. I actually commuted back and forth doing several projects during that time.
Which is, I think, when we met. And because it was also right when you mixed the Zeromancer record, which was the Simon thing. So you came down to Sausalito from Weed at that point. Or not even Weed. I don't think you were up in Weed yet, exactly.
Right. But I was in Mount Shasta, which is a neighboring town. And my husband, Greg, and I got along brilliantly. But I was of the age where it was iffy if I was going to get pregnant, and I didn't get pregnant. So this is the saddest part about being a woman in the industry, is that you reach an age when you're at your peak career and you could, you know, you're hitting the stratosphere, and then you have to make this horrible decision. Do I want to have babies, you know, which completely changes the landscape of everything? Or do I want to just, you know, not have children? So I took that chance. I went up there and there were no babies. So after a year of not working, I started looking around for a way to set up a studio up there and still stay and still stay in my marriage and create a life up there that would include working and creating music. I still owned my console, which I bought I bought it in 94, actually. It's a Neve 8038. And it was living in the B room at Sound City during this whole time. So I found a place, we found a theater in this town called Weed, a beautiful acoustic space. And it was basically abandoned. And so I arranged to have the console shipped up there. And we started a studio called Radio Star. And that ran for 15 years. I can't even believe it. It was crazy busy how it blew up. So that's the true human story of why I left LA. And I've had some opportunities to move back. And now I'm just kind of happy with where I'm at. I'm not with Greg Shivy anymore. That marriage didn't work out. And he has kids now. with someone else.
But, right.
But yeah, I'm extremely happy and thankful that things have turned out this way. I have to say that, you know, I love kids, but babies kill music. that's my theme these days.
Is that what you have written on your baby? Is
yes,
this baby kills music?
I think I have
music.
A bumper sticker that says that.
This baby kills music. Yeah.
Well, you know, as much as I love them, time and time again, we all have friends who have stopped playing music because they have to get serious with their family. And for women, it's extremely difficult to have a family and continue.